Hey guys, how's it going? Hope you guys are doing well. I wanted to bring you a follow-up video on the Camaro project. In the last video, I left off talking about the T56 that I ended up buying for the Camaro, and I wanted to give you guys the backstory on how I got it and what car it came from. As some of you guys may know, the T56 is a fairly expensive transmission, and while looking for one, they were almost all over $2,000. So the search wasn't going too well for me until I found a post on Craigslist for a T56 out of a 2004 C5 Corvette with low mileage. I knew this will not be bolt-on, as the Corvette trans hooks up directly to the differential and the other end to the torque tube. Immediately, I looked online to see if anyone had done this conversion. Thankfully, someone had. They posted information on the parts needed to make the conversion happen with instructions. I did a quick search on part prices and it came out to around $1,000 to $1,200 in parts. I took the chance, met up with the guy, and offered him $580. He was asking for $650. He ended up taking my offer. I was very excited, loaded it onto the truck, drove back home. I was taking a risk and I was taking his word for it. He claimed it was a 30,000 mile transmission. I started looking online for conversion parts, only to quickly find out how hard it was going to be to get certain parts. Eventually, I was able to get all the parts I needed. The majority were purchased brand new. The bell housing was used from Facebook, and the tail housing I got super cheap off an eBay bid. I finally had everything I needed, so I did some research on others who had taken apart a C5 T56, learned from them, and I was able to get it apart. In a nutshell, because the main shaft needed to be replaced with the GTO style main shaft, every little part had to be removed as it sits on the main shaft. This was no easy task. I had taken apart a Civic transmission before to replace the input shaft bearing, but that was a much smaller transmission and it seemed like less parts. I could literally hold the entire transmission with one hand. The T56, on the other hand, was an animal. So many more parts to remember. With everything taken apart, it was now time to reassemble. This was the tricky part. Using the videos on YouTube of others putting back together their LS T56, I managed to put my transmission back together as well. Unfortunately, with the YouTube videos, they were not complete or blurry or cut off at important parts where I was not sure what to do next. Fortunately, I found a site that archived a bunch of pictures of students putting back together their T56 transmissions, and there were several pictures of T56s from different vehicles. I was able to match the parts on mine to some of the pictures, and that helped a ton in being able to reassemble the transmission. One of the most frustrating parts of getting it back together was the guide bolts. These are two bolts that are supposed to be installed from the outside and line up with the inside of the transmission. After battling with these two bolts, I was finally done. The final piece of the puzzle was the tail housing. Put it on, it fit perfectly. The C5 T56 uses a shift rail to shift into gears, but because this was now an LS style T56, I needed to buy a normal shifter. I went online and I was looking for a factory shifter from a Camaro or any cheap aftermarket shifter. I figured they were all the same since I got used to the butter smooth shifting from a Honda. Big mistake. I got a $70 shifter from Amazon, installed it, and the transmission would shift, but it would not return back to center. I was really disappointed. Immediately, I thought something was wrong with the trans. I've never done such a big job and I figured I messed something up. Thankfully, a few days later, after doing more research, I came to the conclusion that the shifter from Amazon was just a crappy knockoff shifter and that the gears and shift rails also probably needed some oil to move more freely inside the trans. I ordered an F-body shifter from MGW Shifters after looking up who made the best short throw shifters for the T56 at the time. TIG Performance has also now started manufacturing short throw shifters and they look and appear to also be very high quality, just like the MGW shifter. I installed the MGW shifter and immediately big difference. Shifting felt much better. It had a short throw and it returned back to center easily. The shifter was the last piece of the puzzle. It was now ready to be installed on the engine. I have more footage of me tearing down the transmission and making this conversion happen. If you guys are interested in seeing a detailed video on making this happen, let me know in the comment section below and I'll try to make this video happen. Anyways guys, that's it for today. Stay tuned for the next videos coming out. Make sure to subscribe, like the video if you enjoyed watching, dislike if you want to. Just make sure to leave some feedback in the comments. Peace.